take the TARDIS for this sort of thing.
Wish I had one of these at home. It'd make trip to the store a lot quicker.
It's like using a vortex manipulator.
Doctor. Thank you. say, this is not the kind of weather that I had in mind when Jenny suggested.
Huh. I guess I'll have to let someone else handle this.
Lego. things in a right 6 and 8. Reckon I could fix it up if you fling us a few studs.
What percentage of you is robot?
Surely one of you would like an honor.
Oh, hello! You made it. Now, come along, dear. I don't want to have to vaporize you. Yet. Now, usually I wouldn't need help in my plotting and scheming, but I'm afraid there are some rather impolite Zygons impersonating a bunch of your beloved humans, but more importantly, your dear old friend Missy as well. I don't think I need to tell you what happens to naughty little copycats that try and steal my thunder now, do I? Help me find them, and I might let you live. You know the saying goes, let Zygons be Zygons, not let Zygons be people. Or time ladies, for that matter.
So, can't help but notice there's nobody here.
Now that is definitely a Zygon. Far too smelly for a human, isn't that? Oh, my dear. Oh, Zygon! Come out, wherever you are. Cheeky little poppets. I just want to say hello. Hello. My boyfriend was here to help. He's got a good eye for that sort of thing.
Tagging out!
I spy with my little eyes. Now there's a big red rubbery smelly thing covered in suckers that we are— There! Now that's better, isn't it? Not a Zygon to be seen. Though I guess they weren't exactly to be seen before, either. But you know what I mean. I did plan on getting rid of you once you helped me sort this mess out, but I seem to have misplaced my vaporizer, so I suppose I should offer you some sort of thanks instead. Now run along, will you, before I change my mind.
From the dawn of time, and I need your assistance in a matter of the utmost urgency. The peace between my race and human life.
Time for Cyborg! I'll be back soon. Don't miss me too much, guys.
Come now, my dear, I will explain everything. A dispute between my Silurian relatives and the humans of this age has broken out, much to my disappointment after years of keeping peace. Unfortunately, my family don't care to be disturbed by humans, resulting in several of them being taken as hostages underground. I would usually ask Jenny and Strax for their assistance on such an important mission. But as you are already here, would you care to restore the peace? We must hurry. My people grow restless with these constant disturbances from humankind. It is only a matter of time before the situation gets out of hand.
Night rises.
Cheers, mate. I won't be sorry to see the back of it. Lead on. Thanks for the rescue. Lead the way. Right. Smells a bit down here, doesn't it?
Grow restless. It appears that all of the humans are accounted for. Excellent work, my dear. Perhaps now they will finally learn not to wake my dear relatives with their ridiculous drilling machines. After all, we were here first. Please, take this as a way of thanks.
Thank you.
must say, this is not the kind of weather that I had in mind when Jenny suggested the short holiday. Good day to you. Such a relief to find someone else here. I'm afraid I got stranded here after a failed experiment with a device that the doctor refers to as a vortex manipulator. To make matters worse, I seem to have stumbled upon an ancient item belonging to the Cybermen. Of course, they're still snoozing away for now, but I was alarmed by the sighting of a number of Cybermans making a nuisance of themselves. If you can help me get the little pests under control, then we won't have to deal with their rudely awoken masters. Now, in truth, it appears as though our cyber friends are being awakened by their corroded companion. Surely, my detective skills never. This shouldn't require anything more than a little pest control. I hope we are. All of these little pests must be stopped before the Cybermen become fully active again. We could really do with speeding the process along, my dear. I don't wish to alarm you, but our cyber friend will soon be awake. Those Cybermen will be tucked away asleep in their ice tombs for quite some time yet. You would be very welcome to join my little household with Jenny and Strax. The Paternoster Gang's door will always be open to you. Now, if you'll excuse me, I really must be getting back home. I dread to think what Strax has been up to in my absence. I must say, this is not the kind of weather that I had in mind when Jenny suggested a short holiday.
had almost forgotten you were here.
Emmett, what are you doing here? Please tell me you haven't been building things.
I've been here before. In a dream.
No, sir.
Hey, fancy doing a little Torchwood mission for me? We got word that the Nestine consciousness has taken over a plastics factory not far from here. Long story short, the Nestines like playing with their human-sized action figures a little too much, and they've brought a bunch of shop window mannequins to life to cause mayhem in the streets. Help me take these dummies down, will ya?
Thank you.
living plastic. If I had a 3D printer, I could clone myself and take me out to dinner. All of them. And if I may say so, you were looking pretty good out there. If you fancy catching up later on, you know where to find me.
Dr. Venkman.
Bye.
Surely one of you would like
fund this restoration at once, or you will be exterminated.
Thank you.
Calm this thing down before I push it off a cliff.
All Daleks must be destroyed. I will destroy the Daleks. My broken manipulator arm must be avenged. Such bullying among the Daleks will not be tolerated. You will assist me in my plan for revenge. Exterminate the Daleks. Exterminate the Daleks.
I know Rusty and Co. have had their differences, but breaking his manipulator arm... Now that just won't do, will it? How about you go off and take this moving dustbin for a walk, and I'll stay here and come up with an over-elaborate plan to destroy you. I mean, I'll stay here and keep guard because I'm so nice.
I am not a good Dalek, but you are bad Daleks. Exterminate! Daleks are evil. Daleks must be destroyed.
I think you got them all, Rusty. Now lay down your lasers. There's a good Dalek.
All Daleks have been exterminated.
Will
but
you stop
another.
Battling on, will you? You big lump of useless metal.
The threat of gratitude towards a human.
Oh, well, for a minute there, I thought I'd have to use up another regeneration. Just when I was starting to have some fun.
This unpleasant feeling of debt must be eradicated. Take this reward so I may no longer feel an obligation towards humans.
Well then, I guess you better take it before this rust bucket changes his mind and decides to exterminate you. And what do you say to our new Dalek friend? Something nice, perhaps? Try. Thank you.
You are welcome.
What a mess. It appears human homes are not built to withstand everyday explosions. There you are, boy. Or girl. Do forgive me, I still don't have that one quite perfected. Anyway, I take it you're here to help me clear up the mess that I... That is, that someone made of Madame Vastra's mansion. Personally, I blame that Jenny character. That boy is always juggling grenades when she thinks no one's watching. So, let's get to work, shall we? I believe that particular ornament is meant to be inverted, isn't it? Surely that was supposed to be inseparable. Well, very odd. Well, personally, I thought that looked better before. But you're the expert. appears Madame Vestris Mansion is in even better condition than before. You have served your planet well, sir. Madam. Child? No matter. The reward for your efforts might not be an accurate identification of gender from myself, but I believe what I do have for you will more than suffice. Take it. For you to face me in glorious battle, you clockwork cowards. My mission is to destroy you all. Greetings, boy. I am reporting to you with an urgent mission of utmost importance. Madame Vestra has informed me that a group of clockwork pests have been stealing parts for their pathetic ship. There is only one solution that I see fit. Grenades! Come, we will challenge them to a fight to the end. I declare war on all clocks. Do not attempt to escape, or you will be obliterated. Another victory in the name of the Santaran Empire! I suppose I should offer you my thanks, madam. Oh, sir, you proved yourself to be most useful in the midst of battle. Now, would you care for a cup of tea? Or possibly some acid?
The situation does look rather bleak.
We can't have Zygons terrorizing the streets of London. It just won't do. I hope you remember to bring some of your famed ammunition, Strax.
Greetings. I wonder if you could assist. A rather grouchy group of Zygons have decided to try their hand at an invasion of London. And it's not for the first time, I might add. This is an operation that could do with a little brute force rather than tact. So I've taken the liberty of bringing Strax along to appease his need for grenades. I shan't think that these Zygons will be able to deal with the three of us combined. Please don't get overexcited, Strax. Anger is always the shortest distance.
Telegram to Inspector Abeline of the Yard. The Zygon threat has been dealt with. Strax, will you bring the horse and carriage around? Oh, wait. Where has he got to now? Oh, I do hope he hasn't been at those jelly sherbet fancies again.
Really heating up around here, and you just can't keep away, can you?
Thank you.
Things are really heating up around here, and you just can't keep away, can you? I was just casually passing by when I saw that some poor, vulnerable ice warriors took a wrong turn on the way home and ended up in hot water, as it were. Now, as I'm sure you remember, they're not terribly fond of the heat, so we should probably see about putting out those fires and getting them to safety. What's in it for me, I hear you say? Well, let's just say I'll be the brains and they can be the brawn when it comes to my next plan to conquer the Earth!
I confess myself disappointed.
Clever. You're not as useless as I first thought. Perhaps I'll let you live after all. Whoops, sorry dear, did I say that out loud?
I love it! Once again, the Joker saves the day! My lucky day!
So, can't help but notice there's... Hey there! You know the face of Bo, right? Big head, serious face, lives in a jar. Well, I heard that his birthday's coming up, and apparently the big guy's turning like a million billion this year. And you can't let a landmark like that go without a bang. So I figured I'd put on a little musical number for him, which we're supposed to be practicing now. But all my backing dancers have gone AWOL. Hey, could you be a pal and go round up those lazy ood?
Oh.
You know, way back when I was a poster boy. All right, this is everyone. We can finally rehearse. Seriously, you guys, the face of Bo isn't getting any younger here. You all ready? Oh, before we get started, take this for your health.